Very good afternoon to all of you. Thanks for joining us here on The Big Story. I'm Afreeza Rehman Ali. We are focusing on the big decision that the Prime Minister has announced just a short while ago. A mega political war, in fact, has also erupted now over renaming Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, the nation's highest sporting honour, after hockey legend Major Dhyanchand. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who made this announcement earlier today, said that the move was based on numerous requests that he has received from across the nation. This has not gone down well on the Congress, clearly. Soon after the centre made this announcement, the Congress has hit back, questioning if the Modi Stadium will now be renamed after a sportsman as well. Congress said that the move is a diversionary tactic by the government to hide its failures. So clearly it raises a number of questions. Earlier in a tweet, the Prime Minister made this announcement that has predictably now provoked a political spat between the BJP and the Congress. Well, we say, sure, this is a welcome move, but can it be extended to all those other awards and sports facilities named after politicians? That is one big question. And like we know, there are already a couple of sports facilities and a national award named after Major Dhyanchand. And therefore, questions are being risen by the Congress party that is this just a diversionary tactic? Remember, prior to this, there was renaming of the Sardar Vallabhbhai Stadium in Ahmedabad to Narendra Modi Stadium. And that is the reference that the Congress is making, asking whether that should also be named after a sportsman by the same logic. In fact, these are questions that we are going to ask today. This one-upmanship over naming and renaming, is it really going to help the players on the ground? They're looking for better facilities. They're looking for opportunities. They're looking for training. How will this help those players who actually go out there to play for us? Remember, like I said, already existing Lifetime Sports Award called Dhyanchand Award is there. So was this again done simply, like the Congress says, simply as vindictiveness is what the Congress party is calling this? Okay, let's first listen into the inputs that we are getting in terms of what the respective parties are saying, what positions they are taking on this. Let's listen in.
Indian National Congress welcomes that the Khel Ratan Puraskar has been named after the one of the most celebrated sports persons, the person known as Hockey Ka Jadugar. We sincerely hope that Modi ji should not have used his myopic political motives to drag the name of a celebrated player like Major Dhyanchand. Rajiv Gandhi ji is not known for any puraskars. Rajiv Gandhi ji is known for his sacrifice. We sincerely hope that instead of being myopic and parochial, Modi ji will truly celebrate the success of our legendary sportspersons.
Okay, I have Mr. Charan Singh Chhapra with me on the phone line. Good afternoon, Mr. Chhapra. The BJP says this is a small token of appreciation to India's hockey legend. The party says that everything in this country has hitherto been named after one Gandhi leader or the other. And this has been a dream, an aspiration of many Indians. We know that sportspersons like Babita Phogat has been requesting for this. Why is this move such an unwelcome move for the Congress party that, you know, members of your party like Shama Mohammed calls it vindictiveness? How is it vindictiveness?
See, number one, I totally respect Major Dhyanchand and his contribution towards the field of sports and hockey. He was a great legend. But the Narendra Modi government, I feel purposely they have done this. Maybe it's a diversionary tactic because there are so many issues going on in the parliament. The issue of Pegasus or maybe Corona or farmers' bill or unemployment, inflation. There are so many issues on which the Modi government doesn't want to reply in the parliament. They don't want to go in for discussion in the parliament. So maybe they have taken this olive branch and to divert the issue. I feel they have shown disrespect towards Rajiv Gandhi, a person who has sacrificed his life for the country. And he has always stood for modern India and the India of the youngsters. You know, he always spoke about the young India. So I feel this is totally a disrespect. And if this government wanted to honor Major Dhyan Chand, there is already an award in his name, and they could have done it in many more ways. Now, we also want to ask Narendra Modi, what is his contribution towards the world of cricket or to the world of sports when he has named a stadium in Ahmedabad after his own name? So the hypocrisy of this prime minister and this government is exposed. And this is a very cheap politics which the BJP has been doing. They were talking, they were saying that they will be the game changer, but they are merely the name changers. And the name changers are not going to go along. They are not going to take the country ahead in a good way as what we are seeing today.
Right, Mrs. Sapra, but you do realize, sir, that, you know, the mood of the country is such right now that there is a euphoria over the Indian hockey team's performance in Olympics. This adds to the mood of celebration, isn't it? I mean, how does it affect any party politics for that matter? This is something that has been done as a gesture to honor a legendary hockey player coming at a time where our teams have done phenomenally well in the Olympics.
Our team has done phenomenally well. Even I was a hockey player in my days, my younger days. But there are many ways to celebrate this. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has especially done a pick and choose thing, and especially to target Congress Party, and especially to target Gandhi family. But he forgot that Rajiv Gandhi is the person who has sacrificed his life for the country, who has fought against terrorism, and who had a vision for the young India, and who wanted India to be a modern India, and the country should rise in the entire world. This is what was the dream of Rajiv Gandhi. Unfortunately, Narendra Modi wants to turn things around, but I don't think so. He will be successful. These are the cheap measures of doing politics, and this government should resist from such cheap politics.
Okay, I have Anila Singh of the BJP also joining us. Anila Singh ji, if you heard what Mr. Sapra had to tell us, is that your party has become a party of name changers, not game changers. These changes are inconsequential in any real tangible benefits for people on the ground or for the players on the field.
They are hit on people of country, whether game changing is doing something good or bad. But it is so unfortunate if the name of this particular award has been changed for somebody who himself is an icon, a pioneer, and an outstanding sports personality who is known as Reserve Discretion in hockey game because he had such control of ball. But at the same time, I'm pretty sure the spirit of Rajiv Gandhiji is going to be so happy about it, the type of person he was. So Congress people, they may do some UN cry, but I'm pretty sure that Rajiv Gandhiji is very, very happy that now the award is going to be in the name of a person who has created history in the field of sports. So I think even they should welcome this.
No, the only question is, Anila ji, whether this will extend to everything else. You just had your party renaming Vallabhbhai Patel Stadium in Ahmedabad as Narendra Modi Stadium. Now, if the logic is, okay, let's honor the sports persons, let's have our sports facilities and awards named after sporting icons, then that should extend all across, isn't it? Let's listen in first to what Dhyan Chand's son has to say. I'm coming back to the conversation.
आज राजीव गांधी खेल रत्न पुरस्कार जो खेलों में सबसे बड़ा होता है, उस पुरस्कार को जो ध्यान मेजर ध्यानचंद जी के ही बर्थडे के ऊपर, जो उनका जन्मदिन है, जिसको कि सरकार ने संसद के अंदर मान्यता देकर इस दिन को सेलिब्रेट करने का अनुमोदन किया था, उस दिन ध्यानचंद जी के बर्थडे के ऊपर ध्यानचंद जी के अवार्ड को उसका नाम बदल के मेजर ध्यानचंद खेल रत्न पुरस्कार किया है। ये फीलिंग, ये बात कहाँ से आई होगी, मैं समझ नहीं पा रहा हूँ इस बात को, जो बहुत बड़ी बात है और बहुत ऊंचाई वाली बात है।
ओके, सो Mr. Chhabra, you heard the son of Major Dhyanchand elated about this decision. I understand that there are already a couple of facilities named after the great player. But then, you know, like the Prime Minister says, it's only fitting that the highest sporting honour should be named after Dhyanchand. It's also the occasion of his birthday. Can't the Congress party be welcoming of this decision at an occasion like this?
No, see, that's what I mentioned earlier also, that we welcome this decision, but Prime Minister could have honored late Dhyanchand in a better way. They could have instituted some another award. There are already a couple of awards in the name of Honorable Dhyanchand. They could have kept another one more award in his name, or maybe some other way. I feel this government is short of some ideas, and they just want to be a name changer, as I rightly said earlier. This is not going to benefit either the country or maybe anybody else. It might benefit BJP to some extent that they have tried to remove Rajiv Gandhi's name from one award.
But Anila Singhji, I need you to respond to this. Are you short of ideas? Is this diversionary tactic? And can this extend to other names that the BJP has resorted to naming sports facilities? Very quickly, Anila ji.
I don't see this thing as anybody's loss or anybody's gain. Because I know one thing very well, not only I, but whole of the world, and especially if I talk about my country, knows very well that what Major Dhyanchand was for these sports, and especially if I talk about hockey, because hockey is our national game as well. I don't know why Congress party is sulking. As I mentioned earlier, that spirit of Rajiv Gandhi ji must be very happy about it. I've got lots of respect for him. And he is not. Okay. I'm pretty sure not for once he must have thought that if the name is being changed for a person like Major Dhyanchand, this award, I think he must have appreciated himself as well. So Congress party.
Yes, that's what we are saying here as well, Anila ji, that this is a welcome move, but it should apply all across. It should not be one isolated example of honoring sports icons. There are other stadiums named after politicians that can change as well. Thanks for joining us, Anila Singh and Charan Singh Chhabra, this afternoon.